Hello. I went to the doctor the other day and found out I had to take medication by injection. And so the nurse taught me what to do. And I just thought, you know, a number of people have asked me about it and say, doesn't that hurt? Isn't that a problem? Aren't you scared? Weren't you scared when you did that? And I said, well, yes and no. But after the first time, it wasn't a problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just share what I learned from the nurse. Okay. Now, injectables have to be kept sterile. And so most of the bottles you'll find, large or small, will come with a metal or a plastic retaining rim and then a rubber dam on the top. That rubber dam is where the needle pokes in to get the fluid out. Okay, and as long as that's intact, then the container is sterile. Now, also, when you get your container from the pharmacy, if there's no label on it, something went wrong, so go back to the pharmacy and have them put a label on it, because you always want to check to make sure it's your name and it's your medicine. Okay, so with that understanding, typically people will use bottles like this, but I've got a bottle of sterile saline solution to use. And understand that this is just for information purposes. It's not intended to diagnose, treat, or tell you that you've got a medical problem, or to even teach you how to inject yourself. This is just to show what I've learned from my nurse, because I had to do some subcutaneous injections, meaning under the skin. But let me explain to you how the process works. If you look at the bottle, inside is atmosphere or air. And when you take a needle and poke into there and take out fluid, the atmosphere is going to change. So what you want to do is keep the atmosphere balanced inside of the container. So if you're going to take out 50 units, you'll need to put in 50 units of atmosphere first, all right? So in my case, I do 15 units, 1-5. Now this needle does 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on, so I would have to then go in between the 10 and the 20, and that is 15. You always need to make sure you're working with a sterile situation. So I have an alcohol swab here. I clean the top of the bottle. Make sure I clean it well. I've already washed my hands to make sure my hands are clean, okay? Because you want to make sure that you stay clean and sterile. I filled the needle up to the 15 point with air. I take off the cap. When it's a fresh needle, it's got a bottom cap on it also. Once you remove that bottom cap, it means that the needle has been used. Never put the bottom cap back on, because you can't use these twice. Now, what I do is I take the needle. In the center of the rubber dam is a target. It's a round circle. And you're going to just, or I'm just going to poke directly into that. Bam. I put in the atmosphere. Now I'm going to turn this upside down. Be careful that you don't let the needle bend like that, because then it's not going to work too well when you go to give yourself an injection. I then use my finger and my thumbs, and I pull down, and it lets the fluid fill into the needle. You got to go a little slow, okay? You know, sometimes people say, well, what if bubbles form inside of there? What the nurse told me is, bubbles aren't as critical when you're going under the skin, but if you're going into a blood vein or a blood vessel, bubbles are very critical to avoid. But under the skin, she said that it's not as much of an issue, so I just don't worry about it unless there's really big ones, okay? So I've got this filled to 15. I pull out the needle. See? It's still holding the fluid in. Now the needle's ready for me to inject. And the injection part is going to be in part two of the video. So with the video of the same name, go watch part two, because this one is over. Two of giving yourself a shot under the skin or subcutaneous injections. The reason I'm doing this video is because I went to the doctor, the nurse taught me how to do this, and so many people said, doesn't that hurt when you do that? And the answer is no, because there really isn't a lot of discomfort when you give a subcutaneous injection near the waist. Now, here are the steps. Of course, you want to have a clean surface area, and you're going to do it away from the belly button. So can you show where the people are going to give themselves an injection, please? Okay, you can't do it through clothing, all right? The first thing you're going to do is you go three fingers away from the belly button to the side. You don't want to be any closer than three fingers towards the belly button, because there's too many sensitive areas. But if you're three fingers away, you're fine. Now you're going to clean the surface area where you're giving yourself the injection. And you can either pinch an inch You've seen that sometimes, or you can just do it directly. These needles are so short that they can't go very far. Okay, so you poke in.
There's my belly button.
There you go, right there. And then you pull back on the plunger, and you look inside of the needle to see if there's any red. If red shows up, you have gotten into a blood vein. So you pull out and reposition. No red, so now you can inject yourself. You just push it in, remove, clean one more time with the alcohol swab, and I always just rub it a little bit, and you're done. So, did that hurt?
Didn't hurt a bit, Miles. I don't think there's a single nerve in that belly fat. I never feel a thing.
Thank you.
Needles
are giving an injection part 3. I went to the doctor the other day, had to learn how to give myself subcutaneous shots, and so many people asked me about it, I thought I'd share it. This is what they told me about disposal of the needles. When you have a needle that is new, it's got a bottom cap and a top cap on it, that means it's sterile. Once you remove the bottom cap, it means it's used. Never put the bottom cap back on, because that then would confuse you to make you think you've got a fresh needle. So once you take the bottom cap off and you've used that needle, that can only be used once, so it's disposable. A lot of people just have a tendency to want to use a plastic bag and put their needles in the plastic bag and then toss it in the garbage. In our area, the local garbage men will not accept needles just tossed in by themselves in the garbage, and they won't even accept garbage cans with bags of needles in them, okay? What I was told is that in some areas you can put your needles in a plastic milk carton and then seal that up tightly. But what we use in our area is a disposable sharps container. Our local hospital says when the container gets 2/3 full, you lock it down. See, this thing's got a thing. You lock it down, return it to them, and they exchange it for no charge for us. Find out if your local hospital does that. Otherwise, there might be a little bit of a cost. Here's how you dispose of a needle inside of a sharps container. Here's the used needle. You toss it in. Just like in a bank vault, you just close and open, and now the needle's inside of there. Never take this off and stick your hand in there, because that's what a sharps container does, is keeps you from getting poked. Okay? And so, that's what this is. Now, this video is not intended to diagnose, treat, or any way tell you you've got a disease, or even teach you how to use needles. It's just to share with you what I learned from my nurse when I went to my doctor.